Alright, YouTube, it's me again. It's another gig day, and this one's starting a bit different because I'm joined by the awesome Ashestoangels. How are you guys?
Ooh.
Pretty good, thanks.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So very recently, you've been nominated for a Kerrang Award.
Doesn't
in my opinion, you should have won. So, just talk us through, like, what it was like, even just to be nominated for such a thing like that.
Yeah, we could basically tell you what it was like up until the point of, like, four drinks in at the awards, and then I know that I was not disappointed because of how fucking incredible it was just to be involved in the whole thing. And I'm not just saying that to sound diplomatic, like, I want to kiss up and suck some dick, right? You invite me to a party like that, you can give me worst artist of all time for the rest of my life, or even nominate me and not even remember to give me that. I wouldn't care. What a fucking party.
Have you ever been to a bar where it's just free booze?
No. I was going to go with, have you ever been to a bar where all of your heroes are there and they want to chat to you, but free booze is good too. Because actually, yeah, when there's flamingos in Bristol, it's basically free booze. It's a fiver to get
in. They don't do that anymore, do they?
No, the straight people found it, so then they had to move.
Oh, God.
But yeah, plenty of alcohol, people, it was good.
So there was definitely lots of people.
Also being nominated, that was crazy. You know who we are? Nobody. Nothing.
Look at everyone else that was in the category. Yeah. They're all ridiculous.
And they spelt our name correctly.
Never
happened. Yeah, but Sean Smith got it wrong. We'll get it next year.
Yeah, it's Sean Smith. We'll get it next year.
Sorry.
You should get it next year.
Well, we'll fucking try.
Absolutely. Yeah, sure.
You kind of touched on it there, working with your heroes. In one of your songs you worked with, I know someone that kind of means something to the band, Wim Control.
Mm-hmm.
Who?
Never heard of him. So, do you want to talk
you
to
say
that?
Aiden.
Working with Will. Right, so there's this thing called Twitter where you post these little messages and people can respond. You can follow people and you can follow people whose music you like. And
not I'll a very well-known thing, Twitter.
No, I think I don't know if it's going to go anywhere. I think that Bebo is going to be the one. Yeah. I tweeted Will to see if he wanted to come produce our record, and then he followed me back, sent me a message with his phone number. I was like, call this number. I was like, all right then. And then he was in my house.
Now we're here.
And now we're friends. It's very cool and very strange. But it's been a pleasure sharing any kind of this journey with him.
He's the homie.
Mm. He is the boy wonder.
So
he's Robin.
Obviously working on new music just now, are we?
I started writing it. We had a lot on. And writing for me is quite a all-encompassing process. And it just starts to devour all of my time, which is great because it makes me write better songs. But just I've been making the band run and doing all this touring and working out, doing all this fucking boring shit that I'm pretty sure it's meant to be someone else's job. But
at some point,
what if they fuck it up? I don't know, man. This is the first tour I've had to actively tour manage, and god damn, I see why they're all bald and angry. From just rage pulling their hair, but it's very rewarding. But we're working on something new. Where the fuck am I? How was that question? It's not going to be this year, but I think we're going to put out two tracks just to tide you over.
Fresh.
Yeah.
Just so people don't start hating you anymore.
Wait.
Who hates us?
They hated us before. Or are they going to hate us more? Do they hate us now and they're going to hate us less?
Why do people hate us?
I don't know, man.
I just want to
be friends with everybody and make a cake made of feelings and rainbows. And we'll all have a slice. Wait. She doesn't even go here.
Oh, excellent.
Taking a lot of cold and flu medication, but I took the nighttime ones.
That's the best way to do it. Do it the other way around.
No. Unfortunately. Sorry, Relentless. They were here for me when you weren't. I'm joking. I've still got the shakes from the Relentless cocktails, man. I can't write anymore.
Everything comes out like a signature.
Yeah, I tweeted them about it. They're like, it stops in 2 days if you're lucky. Except the letters are all fucking all over the place. I have to roughly translate it with my vibrating eyes.
Right, so what do you think will happen in the future then? Obviously, now we've seen you in Kerrang a lot of times because you've had like this all.
Well, we're all going to die in the end.
Sooner or later, one of us will piss off Bulldog and then we'll die.
I love those guys.
Gotta give a big old cheers drive to our drivers on this tour. They've been saved our asses. We can't really give you any details because they're a secret brotherhood of ninja monks. But
comes into my pub.
Yeah. Yeah, they've been awesome.
I don't know how we got here. What was the question again?
Oh. The question is, where do you think the band will go within the next few
hours?
Wherever
people
grind us.
Absolutely. More tours, man. We got some big stuff brewing. We just want to... There's a logical progression to this. If you follow our career back from when I first wrote that crappy song, I was like, it's time. And started trying to find the members. Took a long fucking time. Ha ha. Goodbye, ex-members. And, it's going up and up and up, and it takes work and it takes time, but we just want to keep playing, be able to put out record a year, keep playing shows, try and get that hometown vibe in every city, which we kind of seem to be doing all right at the moment.
Charlie!
Would you like to be in an interview, Charlie?
Do you want to be in the interview?
Do you want to say hello?
Sure, why not?
It's for YouTube.
On,
it's like AOL for videos.
Come on,
everyone. This is the homie Charlie.
Say
hi, Charlie.
Hi, Charlie.
The camera's right.
You can sit across us.
You can sit on my lap.
There's no way.
Sit on my lap.
All right.
Through my lap. Come on. My lamb.
Hello, my love. Hey. Like farewell, my love.
Sorry, I gotta take out my jacket.
Farewell.
That's the Bristolian opposite. Hanging out with the drives is definitely
thing, because we're going to cut to all the highlights from today's show, and then we're going to jump to some fan questions.
Right, so now, it wasn't all bad.
Oh, I didn't play.
I like the end.
It was mine. I wanted to.
Can we do like the bro?
Can you make us disappear? Yeah.
It wasn't half bad. It was all bad.
Sorry?
It was
to disappear.
Sure.
It would be me and Charlie sitting here waiting and you get
naked.
Yeah,
we're naked.
I'm gone. We'll do that later.
I'll try
Wait, let's do the super happy fun ending.
All it takes is a smile.
Right, guys, I know this is a bit of a weird kind of cut, but we are joined by the band you just saw there, Strange Creatures. How are you guys?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah.
We are good.
Yeah, feeling good. Awesome. So, we are recording this the Thursday after the show, so how do you guys think it went for you guys? Obviously, this was your first time playing in Glasgow.
Yeah, first time playing the hometown crowd. I think it went.
It went as well as it could have been. Everything was planned meticulously.
So chipper. Yeah. As well as it could have been. Yeah, we're happy with it.
Everything went to plan.
Definitely.
I think so.
But you're saying this was your debut in your hometown. This wasn't your debut show. That was down in Newcastle.
Yeah. It was down in Newcastle we played for the first time.
How did that go?
Yeah, that went really, really well. Well, basically we didn't play Glasgow first because we wanted to be different and be awkward and weird. So that's why we went somewhere completely different to play first. But yeah, it went really, really well down in Newcastle as well.
Yeah.
It was a good reception from the fans and stuff, because obviously, I mean, I think you've touched on it before, and me personally, some Rebo fans kind of got a little bit mad.
It's went well. Fans have completely embraced the new band and are understanding that it's a complete new thing. So, yeah.
Quite a surprise when they heard what kind of music you're into now.
Yeah, it was...
It's totally different.
Yeah, it was a completely different thing. So.
Kind of done the whole Gerard Way thing.
Yeah, so I just went a completely different, because I mean, if it came out with like a regular band, like if it came out with like drums, bass, guitar again, it would have ended up sounding like Revel.
Yeah.
So I thought it was pointless.
Yeah, fair enough. So do you want to talk us through what happened from the end of Revel and the kind of birth of Strange Creatures?
Yeah, sure thing. Basically what happened was after Revel ended, I was kind of a bit down in the dumps for a while, wrote a couple of songs, Plot came up to just visit me, played them a wee bit here and there, and we decided that we wanted to get something together just to like release an EP, and then we recorded a couple of songs, we really really liked them, and then we basically decided why not just create a band and just go out the two of us.
Yeah, so, fair enough. Definitely. Make electronic instrumentation as well, but with a band element, which is big.
Yeah. So obviously a new band starting afresh, but you do have the advantage of having a previous set of fans. Do you think that'll help you progress as the band?
I think it's helped us progress already, because like it's a lot of the same people are coming to the show still. Like they're seeing the new band, and to be honest, I don't really think they're comparing it to what's came before. It's just
embracing.
Yeah, they're just embracing the new thing and the new band, and the fact that we're making music and being happy with it.
So, what do you hope to achieve with this new band then?
Worldwide domination.
That's what I was going to say. Something unique, something that's never been heard before in this kind of scene that is
kind of developing. Yeah, like to be honest, we just want to do something. We just want to do music that we love, really, and play it to as many people as we can. That's what it's all about at the end of the day. I mean, we're making music just because we love the music we make, and it's kind of like a tip of the hat to the bands we've grew up listening to, so that's been pretty cool.
Fair enough. Right, well, I'm just going to load up some fan questions, so stick around for them. Okay, so thanks for coming back. We got some fan questions for the Creatures now. What's been your favourite band that you've toured with so far?
What would you say?
With Creatures, we haven't really toured a lot with bands. We've just kind of done it ourselves at the minute.
All the bands we've really played with.
All the bands we've played with. That's a hard question to ask. There's been so many, and they're all so beautiful and good.
One exception.
Just one. Oh yeah, but we're not mentioning it. The room got pink.
Oh, nice.
There we go. Anyway, but yeah, there's been a lot of good bands we've played with, and they're all really really fucking good.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll change it up a bit then. One kind of night to play with, let's say, three bands.
One night to play with three bands?
That you've toured with.
Oh, okay. I'm liking that colour. One night, shit.
Ashes would have to
be. Ashestoangels would definitely be there, because they're good guys. I like you guys.
Who else would the fucking put on? Would you had Remember the Unknown?
They're pretty good. Remember, the Unknown are pretty
I think
good.
They've got a lot of potential. Really nice guys.
Yeah, really good band.
Cool.
Maybe Dead. I would say Dead. I love Dead.
Yeah.
Dead are fantastic. I'm trying to think. Eat Meat! I'd love to do a show with Eat Meat again.
Yeah.
Eat Meat are fantastic. If you don't know who Eat Meat are, look up Eat Meat. They're awesome. Nice. Okay, no.
Another kind of personal side. Most embarrassing moment of your life?
Oh, there's so many to choose from.
I just need to dig through the archives.
Yeah. Probably the night I fell on stage. Well, one of the nights I fell on stage.
Was this the night with Fearless?
Yeah. Basically what happened was I was a dick and decided to climb up onto this like high ledge table thing. And I got up there. And whenever I leave the stage, there's always been a rule of like keep playing what we're playing, but for some reason that didn't happen. So I jump. I had like 3 seconds to get back to the microphone to sing, so I jump from this wee ledge thing over the crowd onto the stage. My feet slipped and I kicked the microphone stand on my way down, but luckily enough, and then just like fell on my ass. And then luckily for me, on the way down, the microphone like landed right beside me. So like I just played through the song lying down and played through the rest of the song, then got up and was like, so did anyone see that? And like 300 people were just like, yes, we saw you being a dick. That was quite embarrassing, but I recovered nicely.
I think mine would probably definitely be, using that word, nah. But let's be honest here, I would have to say, when I was in Revolution Reload, we played a gig at Stairway in Glasgow. I'm going to be totally honest once again and say there was not a lot of people there. He had 300 people to look at his disgust. And I only had about 13 to 15.
Mm-hmm.
It was a small gig. But, yeah, it was raging. The snare wasn't tightened on one of the... Well, the snare, obviously. The snare wasn't tightened. And, yeah, just got raging and got up, stood up during my song, just smashed the cymbals with my fist, stolen off stage.
Yeah, he left the stage, right?
Just,
and see, the thing is, right, I was playing away, noticed he went past me. I'm like, oh, he dropped his stick or something, has to go get it. Then I see him leave, and then I just kind of, what do I do in this situation? Apparently my resolution for this was to play the Pink Panther theme. So I was just like, can someone go get our drummer, please? Do 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 do. Doo-doo. I was like, everything will be okay if I just play this riff.
Yeah.
And then I managed to get through it and he came back and we finished the set.
Yeah.
Totally planned.
Totally planned.
Yeah, and then after that I played the best gig of my life.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I played the best.
Not gonna let ask, we kinda had to, the people looked angry.
Yeah.
That's fair enough. Next question, again one, this is one that Ashes could not answer. They gave a list of, I think, 30 to 50 bands and artists.
Mm-hmm.
Who's your favourite band right now?
Oh,
it's always been Radiohead. It's always been Radiohead.
Favourite band right now or just like of all time? The question is right now.
Right now. A lot more difficult for you.
Yeah, it is. Because in my head I want to say Him, because they're like my all time favourite band.
Yeah, yeah.
But right now I've been listening to a fuck ton of Morrissey and The Cure. So I kind of want to say the Morrissey and The Cure. But I kind of also want to list like a bunch of other bands. And there's a lot more, but right now I'd say Him, Morrissey, and The Cure.
Fair enough.
Good show.
Good show. Yeah, I think we did good. We nailed that one.
At least you narrowed it down to 3, though.
Yeah.
Not 30 or 50.
Yeah.
Honestly, I don't know if I'm going to put all of them in, but it was a lot. So if I don't blame me. How do you deal with the haters?
How will we deal with the haters? That's not an arrogant thing, it's just...
it's not arrogant. We probably do, we just don't know it yet.
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, I had an ask for ages, and I used to get a lot of shit on it. And
that did as well, that's why.
To be honest, the way I respond to it is I'm just like, I love you too, babes. Just nicely, with love and affection. Because if you respond... Yeah, because, to be honest, when I respond to them with love and affection, it makes them angrier. Like, they will just spew hate at me from then on. I'm just like, oh, you're so nice, I love you so much. It's like, you don't love me, you fucking prick. I'm just like, oh, babes. Come on, settle down.
Perfect.
So it's the way to deal with
that
it.
That is the best way.
Mm-hmm.
Or just
with love.
I'll just ignore
Give them a hug, that's all they want. They hate because they don't have hugs.
Or a bunch of fives.
So apparently, it's love or a beating from plot.
A bunch of fives. I didn't say that was a beating, but yes.
That could be a bunch of high fives.
Yeah. It's also love.
Also love.
Kind of on the same topic, how would you... Oh, sorry. What would you say to someone if they're getting bullied?
That's a difficult one. Talk to someone about it.
Probably reasonable. But I mean, the people that are doing the bullying are the bad cunts, really.
Just
the bad guys.
Just try to ignore it. Like, talk to someone about it. It's always nice to have someone to talk to about it, because if you talk it out with someone, it doesn't seem that bad. And just know that, I mean, the majority of almost all bullying happens in high school, and that doesn't last forever. Yeah. You know,
it's all tedious, image-based bullying as well.
Yeah. You just... Yeah, basically you've just got high school to deal with it, and then that's it, pretty much over. So just talk to someone about it, try and, you know, sort it out in your own head, and just don't take it personally, because... it's just people trying
just
to, it's just because if you're different, people just want to really attack that, because they're not different, you know, they're just fitting into it with the way everyone else wants them to be, and just be yourself, talk to someone about it, and everything should be fine.
What's the best gift a fan has ever given you?
I have two. A fan once gave me a unicorn t-shirt, which was amazing. I still have it, I love it. And another fan, because gave me a pink t-shirt. Like, pink.
Pink the singer?
Yeah, Pink the singer. Right. I'm a massive fan of Pink. Not many people know that, but I do. Pink gets me, she's my girl. We have heart to heart, you know, me and Pink. Someone hurt Pink, and I know that, and I feel it in her songs. I love Pink.
Who hurt you,
Pink? It's okay, Pink. But yeah, someone gave me a Pink t-shirt, and that was pretty awesome, isn't it?
Yeah.
You got a favourite thing, Flo?
I've not had any gifts given to me, to be honest.
He wasn't really in the band when the gift giving.
Yeah,
was...
if you're out there, a gift giver, just a synth, really, yeah.
I would like a synth, please. Yeah. Nothing big.
Synth. Anything.
One time Pep got Doritos and Rockstar.
Aww.
Which
that's lucky.
Which me and Frenchie kind of took and ate and drank. It was delicious. Thank you, ever gave Pep Rockstar. Because it was Pep got, I got a t-shirt, Frenchie got, I believe it was a hat or a book or something. I don't know how I'm getting those two confused, but it was either a hat or a book, or a book that he used as a hat. Yeah, exactly. Or Pep got Doritos and Rockstar that me and Frenchie took because we were hungry and thirsty.
Fair enough. What's been the biggest impact on your life so far?
Oh, fuck.
What would you say? I mean... I don't know, it's just having people close to you, around you, if you're not having people that... I don't know, is that the answer, actually?
I like how you're asking me the answer for what has been the biggest impact on your life.
I don't know,
maybe playing shows, I think. Playing shows has had quite a massive impact in my life.
Yeah,
you know?
I would even just simplify it even further, just saying getting into music, really.
Yeah.
Personally, I wasn't into music till 14 or 15 or something, in the slightest.
Playing music definitely brought me out of my shell more. I was a very shy person, then I started playing music and going to gigs and stuff.
Yeah.
That was pretty... worked pretty well.
Another kind of favourite question, what is your favourite horror film?
I know what mine is. It's this movie called Sickle, right? This is going to get in depth, right? Me and Plot went through a phase of watching really cheap, shitty, independent horror movies, right? Seriously, these things look like they were made for about £500.
Yeah,
they're so bad.
Like Sharknado?
Yeah. No, worse though.
Oh my god!
This is like properly bad ones, right? And we came across this movie, Sickle. It is like the Golden Globe of all of these. It is amazing.
Golden Raspberry, I'd say.
Oh man, it's so good. Right? There's this bit where this woman's trying to get out of like this vent And she's like, I can't get out of this vent. It's the skirt that's holding me back. And just like takes off the skirt like it's actually holding her back somehow. Oh, it's fantastic.
It was more of a softcore porn film. Let's just see.
And it is so amazing because like there's a bit in it where there's a guy, ironically the guy has a sickle, that is his weapon, and I'm guessing that's where they got the movie title, right? And he like chops this guy and the guy goes, ah! And then like falls down to the ground, so fake and dramatic.
Bagman.
Bagman as well. We all did this! Yeah. Watch Bagman, within the first 5 minutes you will get that reference.
Okay. And the Serbian film.
Okay.
This one goes out to Tom personally.
Tom, among your band work, will you ever go back to documentary work? As one of your sausage monsters was brilliant, and I've always looked forward to your next one. Grin emoticon, regards your oldest fan. Yes. That is my answer for that question. Don't know really what it means. Yeah. But yes, I apparently made a documentary about sausages. It's my secret passion. I love making movies about how sausages are made. Literal sausages, not like porn. But yeah. The next one about burgers is going to be quite epic.
Yeah.
I've been working on it for a few years now.
I look forward to it.
You should.
What's your favourite romantic place?
Favourite romantic place, Tom?
I don't know, I would have to go with it.
Just in the perfect lighting for this question.
Yeah. I would say... probably the key store.
The key store for plot.
Getting out on the brew and shit. That's my love, obviously.
See, I had Celtic Park, I thought that's what you were going to say.
I was about to say that.
Yeah, I knew it was going to be in the head somewhere.
It really was.
Favourite romantic place? What screams romance? I'm trying to think. I can't think of anywhere this romantic. Mm-hmm. Like, the Booze Isle in Morrison's. It's quite romantic.
Yeah.
Solid Rock, it's a bar, that's romance. I mean, I took my girlfriend on our first date to the Solid Rock.
Aww.
I didn't know she was straight edge. I got drunk. Sorry, oh, babe.
She's just sitting over there laughing. It's
brilliant. Again, another question that was posed to Dead. If, no, not Dead, Ashes. Why did I say Dead? Because I said Dead.
Yeah, that's your fault.
I threw you off. If you could collaborate with anyone dead or alive, who would you pick?
You can go first, sweetheart.
The man's name is Richard David James.
Aphex Twin?
Yes. Simple as that.
Why did you have to say his real name?
Because I have to say his name. David James, his middle name. Got to say that.
Collaborate with anyone. See, I'm thinking about it logically. Where, as someone that might collaborate with me or someone that just wouldn't, I would like Robert Smith from The Cure to collaborate with me. And I know he might be up for it, he seems like a sound guy. I would also love Morrissey to collaborate with me, but I don't think Morrissey would even like me very much. Because Morrissey likes no one, apparently. But I love you, Morrissey. If you're out there, somehow stumbled across this video, I love you, Morrissey. Give me a call.
You never know.
Okay, two more.
One is, favourite song and why?
Of ours or just of all time?
Of all time.
I've got to say, it would be Scatman's John Scout. Yeah, Scatman John Scatman. That's just an anthem.
Yeah.
That is a funny anthem.
Or maybe anything by Boyz II Men. They've been my main inspiration for a long time now.
Back catalog. I would have to say, I don't know who sings it, but the song is called How Do You Like Your Eggs in the Morning? Second that I Like Mine with a Kiss.
Yeah.
Boiled or fried.
You know, that's quite romantic, yeah.
I'm satisfied, yeah.
Damn, it's that awesome. I'm trying to think what other songs we've been listening to lately.
But in a serious level?
I don't know. Or maybe Smell Your Dick by... Who's Smell Your Dick by?
Risky and DJ something.
Yeah, check that song out. Why are you coming home at 5 a.m?
Something's going on, can I smell your dick?
Check it out. Good song. God, I hope I didn't get done for coffee right now.
Can I smell your penis?
Okay.
We've got the copyright issues gone now. Thank God.
Brilliant. Last question, and it's a strange one. What would your porn star name be?
I've got this in the bag. Tomacock Polinas. We've had this discussion many a times.
I would have to go the Mitchell Brothers and Gareth Gates.
It's not naming your genitalia. It's your porn star name. But it's nice to know that you're the Mitchell Brothers.
The Mitchell Brothers.
Well, there you go. For anyone that's ever interested, they are...
We are strange creatures.
That's not a porn star name. It's like you're saying your porn star name would be either the Mitchell Brothers, to which there's one of you, so it makes no sense, or Gareth Gates.
But what about David? David Stevenson?
Tomacock is really not as good as Tomacock. No, no, I've got
you
this shit.
You just answered that.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're gonna leave it there.
Yes,
it got. This is the thing I found out. I think I found out a bit more from plot than I ever wanted to know.
Yes.
But yeah, that was Strange Creatures, and we're gonna flip it back to them now. Bye.
Come on, louder. So the last song, this is called Can't Rush It. Yeah, if you got that.
want you to pray that he comes and saves me. I want Wesley to come down and crash it on my fucking head.
Thank you. is the darkness. Yeah, fill my life with broken doors. Let's go! Months, and I know it's because of all of you. I know I've said that every show, but it's because it's true. So here's a song for those of you who've been around since fucking album one. You gotta help us out, especially on the key change at the end. We're not getting any younger on this stage. Except for Jim, he doesn't have a birthday.
Wherever you go, and I'll follow.
There are things that
My words can never save me. I'm Yeah.
checking in, watching.
Oh yeah! With a rusty spoon! Anal.
Go
away.
Thanks for watching this again, and you've been rewarded with some fan questions with these guys.
No, we haven't.
We'll jump into the first one. If you could collaborate with anyone, dead or alive, who would it be? Oh, and that's from Anna Godden. Of Goodden?
Jesus Christ.
Anna Goodden?
Should we go in a line?
Wait,
go in
the what line. Was the first option?
Dead or alive?
Dead or alive.
If you could work with anyone.
Work with anyone ever.
Johnny fucking Cash.
Fair enough.
I'm going to say Diane Wood.
Yeah, that would be
that
weird.
That would be fucking awesome, right?
That would be pretty good. Tupac?
Yeah.
Oh. Fair enough.
Freddie Mercury.
Pretty good.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah.
Well, I've got the easiest answer since they said those artists. Michael Jack. There you go.
I didn't want to
Michael
take Jackson. It from you.
Yeah, I was waiting. I was like, is one of them going to say it? There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
Definitely.
Right, excellent.
Like a really harsh guitar solo on top of my track.
Apologies for this one.
I should know this.
What is your porn star / prison bitch name?
My porn star name is Gracie Close. It's the classiest bitch name.
Mine is Stingray Portsmouth.
What was it? What was the like?
His first pet and road name where you were.
Brandy Sand.
Wait, what's it? You had a pet Stingray?
No, Stingray was the name of the goldfish. He had a sister called Marina who died that night, and Stingray lived for 11 years. And he was so fucking sad the whole time. It's like, yes, I'm alive, but why am I alive? And they've got no real long-term memory, so he's just constantly like, oh, Marina? Oh, she's dead. It was hard to watch.
What would yours be?
Shadow Libby.
Shadow Libby.
Yeah,
I've had trouble with Shadow Libby. Tom Frampton. Mustache. You can hear the mustache on the R of Frampton.
Yeah. Got that flavor saver going on.
You got a dog called Tom. No, cat.
You had a cat called Tom. Oh, Tom cat, I guess. Yeah. Yeah.
Really cool. Dickhead.
Very bland animal name. Glenn.
Okay, this question's another weird one. Cool. What is the weirdest liquid your toes have ever touched?
Shitty water that's been laid on that bus.
Recently, yeah.
Mine is, I let our old bass player vomit on my feet because we're at a festival and he was just being sick, so he was just drinking loads of water because he was so hungover, but it was cold and the festival was hot. I was just like, that looks kind of refreshing. So I just put my feet under his stream of vomit and he was just sipping them for a while.
I think mine's probably vomit as well. Yeah. Trying to think what else I put my feet in.
Yeah, I don't know.
Anything really.
I put my like. If you're eating and then like mayonnaise goes on your foot, does that count? Like,
I'd say so.
Like, yeah, pretty much every food that's wet, it's probably been on my toe at some point.
Hummus.
Lots of hummus on my toes. Like, it's not a fetish, but.
Yeah.
Do my best. Definitely acrylic saliva. So yeah. Yeah, first day of tour. Crazy shit happens.
We just spat on his foot.
What happens on tour stays on tour, guys, just remember that.
It doesn't
all the time.
It fucking doesn't.
Not with Instagram.
It follows.
Yeah, I have no fucking idea. Go to the next one, I don't know.
Okay. Next one. If you had something tattooed across your forehead, what would it be? From Harley Goodfrey again? Damaged. No, sorry. Different person.
Oh, Harley.
Damaged.
Yeah, Joker. I like.
Yeah.
Separate question before we go back into this one.
On my forehead or on my entire face?
It's just a forehead, but what do you think Jared Leto will be like?
I think he's
going to
kill it.
It's going to be so good. It's going to be like a comic book.
His future is pretty far up there, so I don't know.
But his voice...
They're all so different.
His voice sounds like Jack Nicholson in The Shining. It sounds like the, I'm not going to hurt you, I'm just going to bash your brains in.
Yeah, but Heath Ledger did the Tom Waits thing, and I think that's fucking awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, but also Heath was like a real world Joker, the same way that... Christian Bale's a real world Batman, whereas Suicide Squad I think is going to be more of a comic book movie.
Yeah.
And it ties in with the DC universe, which is it has all those fantasy characters. Also, I think he's going to be great.
Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn.
Chilling Joker laugh.
Looking beautiful.
He's good.
So good. Can't wait for her to come out. It's going to be sick.
She better be good. She better not just be like, look how good looking she is and that's enough. Like, no, we need character.
What, have you seen The Wolf on Wall Street?
Yeah, exactly. Like her accent.
Oh shit! Was she?
That's her.
Yeah.
That's her. Oh yeah, she's gonna smash it.
That's what I mean. Like her accent and stuff. Like she can go kill it.
Right, so going back to the forehead question,
though. Yeah.
Oh, what would I have tattooed on my fucking forehead?
What is it that guy has that you hate?
Perfect eyebrows.
Oh, it says something inside.
Charlie's face instead of eyebrows.
Yeah.
Huh?
It'd be creepy. I don't know.
Eyebrows?
I'm going to have Charlie's face instead of eyebrows.
Oh, okay.
On either side.
Cool.
Yeah.
What would it be?
Oh, man.
At least mine's serious.
It would have to be a lyric, definitely.
In my head, it's just like bowed across. Like, maybe a hairline tattoo. But you never know where your hairline's going to be in 10 years.
Yeah. Might look bad.
What did you say, Jen?
Just eyebrows.
Oh, okay.
Perfect eyebrows.
Up here.
Just on
the second set.
Yeah.
You can have a line tattooed across where your hairline is. You can see how far it's receded across the next few years.
I don't know, I would never get one, so that's going to be my answer.
Yeah, I'd rather cut off my own face.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a good looking face. I don't want to ruin. This is like the moneymaker, so I can't really.
He sleeps with it in a hyperbaric chamber.
Yeah, I do.
It looks like a fishbowl. I made it for him.
You did?
Your brothers.
That's so nice, isn't it?
Keeps you young and pale.
It's a tiny amount of uranium.
Gives you that glow. Yeah.
Really quick, though, what time do I go on?
Oh, shit. I think probably about 20 minutes.
Okay, I should
maybe you should go.
Bye,
Charlie.
Thank you.
Farewell.
It's been a pleasure. So I'm going to, you know, get ready.
We'll be in because you guys are going to fucking, it's going to sound so good.
Yeah, I'm so stoked. See you right there.
They've been smashing it every day. They give me fear.
Nice.
Yeah. Fortunately, we've been drugging their straight edge singer, so he's going to be a mess tonight.
they give me a fear boner.
It's different.
Next question.
Next question.
What gives you a fear boner? Oh, well, that's handy.
That would be too coincidental. But what is the best / worst fan experience you've ever had?
Damned cats.
Well, killing one of them was very hard, but not as hard as getting rid of the body and the satisfaction of getting away with it was
better run.
Excellent.
Are you sure that's something you want to admit to the world here?
Oh, I didn't kill
anyone. They're not going to find the body.
I'll kill them as well.
I don't think we've ever had
that. Yeah, largely it's been absolutely positive because we don't give a shit about online bullshit because that's not fucking real and you should never care what some cunt says to you on the internet. Fuck them. But in real life, the people who come and see our band are amazing and they're family and they're all fucking awesome, so nothing bad happens. And we're weird anyway, so we don't really know what weird is.
Better to be weird
than normal. This is weird. Our lives are weird and it's awesome.
Our lives are dope.
We do dope shit.
Yes.
Brilliant answer. Okay. Maybe a hard one. What is your favourite song and why?
I don't know.
I fucking know such thing.
I can't pick one. Anyone who says that they have one is resistant to change and that means that you miss out on things.
It's just impossible.
Nah. What's your favourite song?
King and Rob Zod by Bella Talent.
Fucking good song.
Go around, like, let me have a think.
Okay. I literally couldn't give you one.
It's fair enough.
So hard.
What would you change it to favourite band? Except yourselves. In case anyone's tried me wide and say.
Can't do that either.
It changes.
Jesus.
Yep.
A new band will come out and I'll obsess over them for a good 6 months. And another one will come out.
Fucking
IMX and him. I'm easy.
I don't know.
Use a couple then.
Aiden, AFI, Misfits, My Passion, Ashestoangels,
Creeper,
yeah. Fucking Creeper. AFI again, Alkaline Trio again, Farewell My Love, Dead 13.
Never bring up our homies' names because we always forget the other ones. Like, what other bands are we friends with that we're forgetting to shout out?
Pretty Addicted.
Pretty Addicted, yeah, see?
Your mate.
Yeah, I can't pick a favourite band. You know how many good bands there are? Like 19 at least. Maybe 27.
There you go.
So if you have those 27 bands on your phone, you're good.
Yeah.
And then look
I've
for
got
music.
More than 27 bands on my phone, which must mean I've got some fucking awful music on my phone.
27 good bands and Bring Me a Horizon, they're fucking incredible.
No, yeah.
No. You can't pick that stuff. I think also as you get older and you are more open to new stuff. The used, fucking used. Yeah, you can't.
We can go.
You can't stay locked down.
Like,
this question is basically which music is good, and the answer. I mean, fucking, we haven't even crossed genres at the moment. We're sticking with things people know we like. Fucking underground UK hip hop. Akala, Tupac Shakur, Biggie Smalls. I feel like he's got the more consistent output. Tupac, he was more about smashing out as much as he could.
Tyler, the Creator.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Sandwiches, what a fucking song. Jeez. Sage Francis, Down the Sack versus Scroobius Pip. B. Dolan. Clayton Blizzard.
Oh, the Bristolian, man.
Look, we should move on.
Yeah.
Because we'll miss our set.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe just make a separate video with that. if you weren't...
We'll sing it to the tune if we didn't start the fire.
If you weren't who... What the hell?
If I weren't who I am, then who would I be?
Yeah. Basically, if you weren't yourselves, who would you be for a day?
I've got a good answer for this.
Go.
I got him.
Kai. Because if I wasn't here, I'd probably still be Kai.
I don't know if it works like that, but you do. Alright.
I have no idea.
Jared Leto's girlfriend. You're gonna get fucked, you get done right.
Truth.
This has not been our most PG-13 interview, to be honest. Is this a part of our career where we're trying to like get edgy and... Like, shake, it's like when One Direction start playing instruments and be like, we're a serious band. Like, oh, hello, welcome to our interview. Fuck everything. Nihilism is a positive concept and we don't even believe in that. Anti-everywhere us. We're not like that.
No.
Nice. I'd have a Death Star, kill us all.
Where are we?
I'd be Tupac because he lives. And then I'd find out where he is. And then I'd tell real me.
Help me. I like that.
No, help me.
That's a good answer. Again, next question. If you could only drink Diet Pepsi or vodka for the rest of your life, which would it be?
Diet Pepsi.
Oh, you man,
we sound rock and roll.
First of all, if I only drank vodka for the rest of my life, I'd kill every single one of you. Everyone I came into contact with. Also, have you ever tried to stake your thirst with vodka?
Yes.
Or accidentally drunk
it at a festival? Who asked that question? That was by Vickie, Curses and Cures.
Ah, you. Lisa, you come in the door.
Do me another in.
I said it was the giant blue bus. It's just someone else's bus, like... Hello? A Chinese family would not stop screaming. What was the question?
I shit a squirrel.
Right, the next question was, when's the next album due?
But next year.
Like next year.
Sometime.
Yeah. And I'm touching on this again, but kind of focus on it a bit more. Mm. What are you hoping for in the future?
Everything bigger.
Yeah. This and, but more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
More people.
Make more friends.
My problems.
Yeah, male problems for sure. Find Tupac Shakur. He lives.
Alright, well, that was the interview with Ashestoangels. I'd like to thank all of you very, very much. And I'd like to thank Lisa, who's just walked in the door for setting this up. Thank you very much. And thanks for watching the video. I will see you at the next gig or whatever video I decide to do.
This has been MTV Cribs, right? Let's do the super sad ending. Oh no, the bus! The bus!
Oh my God, the whole bus is
dragon attack!
Alright,
dragon attack?
Guys. Okay.